Back at it again with the Diamondback hook. As you can see, I've done a few mods to it. Out here at this lake, I'm trying to be careful. It's kind of dark. Water's kind of murky, and we do have gators out here, so I don't want to get too close to that. But had a little rain making the water murky. You can see the Diamondback hook. It's looking pretty good. Serving me pretty well. I'll go over the mods I've done so far. I say I'm done, but I'll probably keep tinkering with it and adding things, but it's mostly done from where I'm at right now. Look at that thunder up there. So for the necessities, I got the lights on here for nighttime use, which I really don't do too often, but when it's getting a little darker, I'll cut on my blinkers on each end. For my rear light, I don't know the name of this, but just type in laser light or whatever onto Amazon or eBay or whatever. And this thing is rechargeable, and it's got these lights in the back which work great at night. And it's also got another button for a laser which shoots on the ground. You can't see it now in the daytime, but you get lasers on each side, like a laser lane of your bike when you're riding at night, so people see you a lot more. So those can be solid, they can blink, and they're excellent. I love them. You can kind of see it right there. There's the blinking. Okay, it's off. Okay, yeah, I thought it was that one. That's my back lights. I like to keep both those on just for extra visibility at night. Got my front blinker. These are just cheap ones you can get online for like $1 or something a piece. Or they come free with these actually. And these are the Vaunt. I don't know what they are, but they're like $12, $15 a piece for these, and these are great. Big reason I like them is they have this ring around them, so you can see it from the side. People will see you from the side at night. In addition to your lights that come out here, you can adjust the width of the beam and everything. Pretty cool. So I have two of those. I don't use them often, but they're good to have when I need them. Here I've got the Race Face Chester pedals, which are excellent. These screws are replaceable. They're very grippy, and I think most of the parts inside here, this inner part, these screws and everything are replaceable. Pretty cool. But I think with just the hassle factor, if you really think about it, these are 40 or 50 bucks. Probably just better to buy a new pair and toss the old ones or put them on a bike you're not too crazy about. But I'm digging these so far. I was riding out here and these things are basically glued to my riding shoes, just, you know, regular boots I'm wearing right now out here. But yeah, they're awesome. That dark red looks so good with the 2019 Diamondback hook, that nice dark red color I like. Very cool. And they have these in different colors for different bikes or preferences or whatever. But they're excellent. Got this gel seat cover because the seat is kind of rough. A lot of people don't mind it, but I like having a little cushion there when I'm riding. Especially on these rough trails, you want your contact points to not throw as many vibrations through them as possible. Same reason I got these. Makes the ride a lot more comfortable and better on your back and body and everything. I forgot what brand it was, but it's like 12 or something dollars on Amazon. Just type in gel seat cushion red or whatever color and they'll pop up. I forgot what brand it was. Got my red Enduro Sports frame bag here, which is pretty cool. Keep my glasses, my wallet, my keys, my little phone, and gear and stuff in there when I'm riding. Great frame bag. I got it on Amazon, I think, I want to say around $12, $15, but not bad. I don't carry a lot of junk with me when I ride, but I don't like my wallet and keys and everything banging into me when I drive, so, or ride, so. Great little addition for a good price. It's held up well so far. Need to clean it. It's got a bunch of mud and crud on there, but no big deal. for my water bottle cage, I got a, how do you say the Bontrager? Probably some weird pronunciation I can't do, but it's a great little bottle cage. Nice dark red color that matches my bike perfectly. Love it so far. I do wish this bike had a second cage holder, but whatever. And then I got my Bicycle World Texas bottle, which I just got locally. It snaps in there, fits perfectly. Doesn't go anywhere. I got these both at the same store. I think I got them at the local Bicycle World, which is a cool little place. Lots of good accessories and things like that. But yeah, I love the look of it on the bike. Matches perfectly. So here I've got the Wolf Tooth Fat Paw grips. And I gotta say, these are the best bike grips I've ever owned or used. 100% silicone, nice dark black color, which matches my tires and bike and everything. I did have some red ones on here, but they were a really kind of bright red that didn't match my bike or whatever, and I felt like they would look pinkish with time and sun exposure. So I put the black ones on. They look pretty good. They match the tires and the black features of the bike. Nice grip. The thing I like about them, they take the shock and everything off your arms and your hands when you're going up the trail and everything like that. So I love that. Cool end caps. They're pretty excellent. Highly recommended. And these are a little bit thicker. I think these are the thickest grips you can buy on the market for bikes. There's the other brand, I forgot what they're called, the Chunky Grips or whatever by ESI. They're a little bit smaller than these. Some people don't like these. They say they're too big for their hands, but I'm 6'4", ride the XL frame. These are perfect size for my hands. Not too big. I could actually use a little bigger and I'd be fine. So no big deal. I ride typically like this, resting my hand just casually on the trails, and they're excellent. Now we're getting into goofy little stuff that doesn't matter, but these are the brick red Presta valve stem caps off of Amazon. They're American made brick red color. I bought a more bright red color earlier and I took them off and I put these on because they match the frame, the dark frame of my bike, a lot better. So small little detail, but I think they look cool. Not necessary at all. Just tinkering and OCD basically. But pretty cool little bike. What else do I got on here? Not a whole lot else to talk about. Besides this, I'm keeping most things stock. I probably won't change the tires or anything. But some people, you know, will change the cap on this wire, make it red or whatever color matches their bike. I don't care. If this comes off, I'll probably get a red one, but for now it's fine. There's not a lot I need to do on this bike though. Pretty cool. Let's see if I can find a gator out here. I kind of want to hunt one. Get some good gator leather, some good gator meat. But I'm not doing that on my own out here without a tag. So yeah, that's it. Great bike though. Highly recommend it. So that's the mod so far. I say I'm done, but I'll probably keep tinkering with it. So I'll let you know in the comments if I change anything. Let me get out of Gatorville out here. A couple final notes on the Diamondback hook that I forgot to mention. Some smaller things, but still worth mentioning. Such as the red zip ties. You can get these like any Walmart or local store. Just make sure when you cut them and you put them through here, that the sharp part is on the inside. You can also nip that off, but I stick them through the way where the round edge is on the outside. And the pointy part is on the inside, so you don't have to worry about it. Just to give the bike a cool little clean look instead of the black zip ties. Not a big upgrade, but kind of a cheap, cool one if you want to do that. Also got the old Word lock. I recommend having one of these and then like a U-lock. You're really going to lock this outside, which I typically don't have it locked up in my place. But the cool thing about the Word lock is you can use any word of your choice. Now I noticed they took out the C's and certain other letters, so you can't have too much fun, but if you're inventive, you can make it work. I'm gonna change that, by the way, so I'm getting the ideas. But yeah, cool bike. Another thing about these Race Face Chester pedals, I think they actually make the ride easier on your legs because they glue to your feet a lot better and they grip a lot better. So it almost makes the whole ride easier on your legs and your calves and everything like that. You're not struggling as much to stay on the bike, especially on heavy trails or whatever, which I'm not on right now. I'm nowhere crazy, just a light trail. But excellent bike, highly recommend it. I'll probably do a few more upgrades and tinkering to it, but this is pretty much as non-stock as it's gonna get. And then I have a red helmet, red gloves, and all that stuff I use when necessary. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Thanks for watching.